Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So this video is to bring awareness to what is going on in both of our countries, in Cuba and also in Haiti. I want to start off by saying we want peace. You know, we want positive results in our countries. And overall, I think we can truly say that, you know, with unity, by people spreading awareness to what is going on, it can bring in positive results. So Julio, I know, is gonna be talking in Spanish a little bit, so, you know, I'll make sure to have subtitles below, but I want him to be able to be comfortable in everything that he says because he's lived in Cuba for over 30 years. So, you know, he knows the in and out of the life in Cuba and everything that he's experienced on a day-to-day basis. And I think it's really important that people know, you know, what is going on in Cuba. So we just wanted to bring awareness, make this video to show that we are proud of the Cuban people, and also for Haiti as well, to bring awareness to, you know, the assassination of our president, Jovenel.
Están pasando muchas cosas en Cuba, es muy difícil en Facebook ahora mismo. Piensen, pues vaya, han quitado el internet. Es una cosa lógica para que la gente no vea la realidad de lo que está pasando ahora mismo en Cuba. Los policías le quitan el uniforme y están vestidos de civiles, reprimiendo al pueblo. Supuestamente la televisión cubana o al mundo quiere decir que el pueblo está luchando contra la contrarrevolución. Que es un problema de Estados Unidos, pero hoy toda La Habana, no es La Habana, Camagüey, Santiago, todos están en las calles. Entonces, a Estados Unidos le pagó a toda esa gente que estuvieran en las calles. Es porque no hay la pandemia, es difícil. Pero están los hospitales, mal condiciones los hospitales, no hay medicina, se están muriendo la gente. Es difícil conseguir alimentos. Demasiadas cosas juntas, se va la luz. Es muchas cosas juntas ahora mismo que ya es demasiado difícil la situación ahora mismo. Y fuerza Cuba, fuerza mi pueblo, que están en las calles ahora mismo, pero...
He's expressing, you know, how the hospitals have no medicine, there's no internet, even getting food, you know. People had to stand in line from 12 a.m. just to get food, right when the store opens at 6 a.m. and there's over 100 people standing in line. And there's no guarantee that they're gonna get food. Needless to say, I am so proud of the Cuban people to, you know, go out into the streets, para la calle, to fight for Cuban freedom. You know, they are tired of starving to death, of not being able to reach out to their families, having to pay for a Wi-Fi card just to reach out to their families in different countries. I will say this, I know a lot of people have opinions, you know, on what the Cuban people need and, you know, this and that. I think what's most important right now is for you to reach out to the Cuban people and hear their voice on what they need. I think now they're fighting for that voice, so I think this is the perfect time for everyone to stop forming opinions on what they need and reach out to them and, you know, get their voices heard. I can't speak for the Cuban people on what they need because I haven't experienced it. I've only seen it with my own eyes. But I can truly say I am very, very proud and I'm hoping for positive outcome from this.
Fuerza Cuba, cojones.
Also for the people in Haiti, I'm hoping for justice for what has happened to our president, and I'm praying for positive results for our people, and I'm praying that, you know, we see change in both Cuba and in Haiti. So we thank you guys for watching this video. Please make sure to share. Please make sure to hashtag SOS Cuba. You know, share any poster, meme you see about, you know, spreading awareness for Cuba as well as for Haiti. We thank you guys for watching.
Bye, guys.